how we are playing a critical role in the big data space using artificial intelligence. So we'll start with the pain points. So everybody knows that we have a lot of data everywhere, worldwide. And especially in large corporations where data are sitting in their servers. And a lot of these data are just sitting there doing nothing. So it's all wasted. So this is the big pain points. And also what you see is some companies use their data, but only internally. You will rarely see any data that links with any external organization, right? So what we're trying to solve here is trying to link data between organizations. So not only let data flow internally, but also let it flow externally. So this is the concept. The first concept that we're trying to create here is called data fusion, which is really amazing to share with you guys. So what we call it is called Data Fusion Value Chain Network. In short, we call it DVN. So this is where data from different data sources are able to link and fuse together. And this will create a much more complete user profile of data. So there are four processes inside of DVN that I want to walk you through. So the first process is data collection. Right? In the collection process, the most important part is the data connection with the different sources. And also we can do data crawlers to collect data. So this is the important part, is the gateway that we design, the APIs that we need to interface with different data sources. And after we have the data providers into the DVN, the next step is called data governance. And what it means is really just refining of these data. So the processes include cleaning and tagging. So let me give you a simple example. If we're collecting a bunch of phone numbers coming in from a global level, you would have the area code, the country code, the plus, the brackets. So you get a collection of these cell phones in different various formats. But before they store into a database, they need to be cleaned into one single format. So let's just give you an example of data cleaning. And tagging is easier to understand. For example, like I have a family, I have a child, right? I have a car, I have a house. So all these are tagging. So before these data are stored into DVN, we have to clean them and tag them. And the most important part is called data fusion, which is the third step. So let me give you an example of ID mapping, how we're using ID mapping technology to fuse data. So imagine you are spending with a Visa Master credit card when you go shopping. All your expenditure data are recorded by Visa Master cards, right? And imagine you're also going on Google to search and logging to YouTube, for example. Right? So they log in, they capture your email as your primary ID. Right? So you have to sign in with your email addresses. And whatever that you search on Google, all that data, the user behavior is being captured. Right? So what's really interesting is how do you know who is who? Right? You have used your Visa MasterCard while shopping, and you have done some Googling on the website, but how do you know this is one person? So the ID mapping technology makes this happen. And for example, if we had your mobile phone and had your mobile device ID, then we know this is you who spent this much at shopping and you are also searching on YouTube. Right? So this ID mapping technology builds, links all the data together that belongs to one person. So this builds a more complete user profile. So we know everything about you. We know where you have been shopping, where you've been spent money, what you've been searching for on websites. So we know everything about you. So this is the ID mapping part that fuses the data together, which is the most important process inside the DVN. And finally, after we have all this data, we can provide services to privacy. So what's really important is the authorization part. So a user has to be authorized to use applications. For example, if you want to subscribe to YouTube, you've got to agree to their terms, right? So that's an authorization process. And every authorization process is stored in our product. We call it multi-trust connector. So before gaining access to your personal data, the data providers wants to see that you have been authorized properly before giving the access to their data. So I'll explain a little bit more about the multi-trust connector in the next page. And also we have the ability to go into different sectors and different applications once we have all this data. So we provide services to different industries. So quickly about the multi-trust connector. As you can see on the right, it's very complex system in the back end. But to make it really simple for you guys, there's a third-party authorization and confirmation application. So every time you have authorized an application, this needs to be stored on MTC before you gain any access to our data fusion network. So more applications of scenarios, right? So what can we do with all this data fusion, the DPN network? Well, simply you can see credit investigation exactly the scenario. So it gives you a score rather than give you data. So you'll never get your privacy data leaked, but you'll get some sort of yes or no answer, some sort of scoring, or some sort of rating. So that's what you'll get. And that is done by our artificial intelligence model, right? So we're not giving data out. And other scenarios, business intelligence report, right? Banks, insurance, automotive. I can give another example in automotive, right? So let's go back to the example of like Visa, MasterCard, right? So they have all the data of you purchasing different things and your ability to afford, right? They'll know whether you have the ability to afford luxury cars. So let's say a customer is Mercedes-Benz. Right? They want to know who are the potential buyers of Mercedes-Benz. And through Visa and MasterCard data, we will be able to analyze who has the ability to purchase Mercedes-Benz. And through another data source, let's say Google's data, that they know if you have been recently searching for luxury cars on websites. So if we had, imagine we had those two data sources fused, we would know very accurately whether you have the intention to buy a luxury car, as well as whether you have the ability to purchase a Mercedes-Benz. So we will get a much more accurate results from this DPN. This is an example. So here is a structure of our platform. So in very high level, this is a customer, for example, could be Mercedes. What happens is it sends an ID request. So it has to have certain ID that goes into the DBM. And then there's multiple IDs goes into the data sources. And of course, there's the MTC we talked about, which needs to have authorization before gaining access. And there's the regulatory agency, in case government wants to check if this is valid, right? Then that's how the whole system works in this structure. So this is very high level for you guys to understand. So the token economics, you'll ask, so where is the BBN, our token, is used? So the customers will need to spend BBN to gain access to the data fusion network. And of course, then the data sources are the ones that are gaining BBN. And data cleaning parts, how that works, that we have third-party participants to come in to clean data. And these people will be rewarded with BBN as well. And another cool thing I want to mention here is the Banyan network members. So if you have already authorized to many different applications previously, you could also authorize to us. And the benefit is that every time your data is used, we'll let you know, we'll notify you, as well as giving you a reward of VPN. So previously, your data is being used without your awareness, and now you know, you get to control your own data. So that's why we ask and encourage everyone in the world to become a Banyan member. And a really critical thing to mention here is GDPR. We are following GDPR. And for those of you who doesn't know what GDPR is, it's the way to protect users' privacy. There's a series of guidelines, and one of the most critical guidelines is user needs to opt in. So there's a little checkbox, so you have to click on it, and that is opt in into their agreements before you use the applications. Right? So Facebook, Google, everywhere you go, every app you use, there needs to be some sort of checkbox that user needs to agree. Otherwise, you cannot use the app. And user has the ability to delete or request a deletion of their data from the database. So that is what GDPR is talking about. Right? So you can also gain a copy of your data as well. So again, here's the becoming a Banyan member to get BBM reward. You get to control your own data. So here's our roadmap. So in other words, a little small, it's on our website. A couple of key timelines I can mention here. One is we have our gateway finished, version 1. So this means that we can now get data connection, data providers to come into our DBM. So this was completed in May of this year. And this means in September, we will be able to provide data services to customers, but not in a fusion method, but at least from one single source to a customer. Where the fusion actually happens is next year in Q2. So we expect by Q2 next year, we'll be able to fuse different data sources, where this will open up more opportunities. Quickly about ourselves and our team. So I'm a Canadian citizen, and right now I reside in China. And my past entrepreneurships has been in Boston and in China. I'm a graduate from the University of Waterloo. So I've been a serial entrepreneur and angel investor in the past almost 8 to 9 years. And my co-founder, Kelvin, so he graduated from Beida University. And he has been the founder of UnionPay Smart, which is a daughter company of UnionPay that handles all the big data. And finally, our CTO, Yizhou Liu, and he's from Tsinghua University and also from Caltech. And he is also a serial entrepreneur in the Silicon Valley and now joined us in China as well. So quickly, let's go through, we call it a theory of three data values. So this is something that we created ourselves, actually by Kelvin, who has been an expert in the big data sector. So siloed data accelerates the evaluation. This means that if data sits in a server, does nothing, there is no value. That's what it means. And circulating data generates value. So this means once we start to use the big data and generates some decisions based on AI, there's a lot of value generated, right? So like these days when you go shopping, like on Amazon, it knows what you're trying to shop, what you're looking for, it's guessing your next move, right? So that's why data is really valuable. And finally, fused data promotes value add, and that's what we talked about DBN today, and the four steps in DBN. And what's really cool in the future is that anyone in the future can go through the DBM process, the four steps. This means it doesn't matter how big or small your data is, it could be a very small data source, but you can upload that. And if your data is being accessed and used, you'll be rewarded. So anyone, big or small, can can come to TVN, upload your data sources, and there's a potential that your data is used in the right way and you'll be rewarded. And so are the customers getting much more better decisions out of our TVN. So that's my presentation for today. And here's our website. You can Google Banyan Network, or you can come to our website to see the roadmap that we have just updated on our website. Yeah, thank you.